Check.
Folks, I'm gay. Am I picking up? Can you guys hear me?
I'm hearing you.
Yeah. Okay. I hear you. Why?
I think my headphones are fucked.
Yeah, Adam probably plugged this shit in.
Oh, there we go.
Yeah, Adam.
No, it wasn't the plug. It was that your headphones.
Yeah, but here's this.
But
is,
it was
you
did it.
Plugged it in wrong, and I told you not to do this. You say, "Well, it's closer to me," but then when he can't hear something, I go to the
channel.
Yeah, exactly, which is wrong.
I should be in the third.
You should be in the third.
You can switch it. Switch it right now.
It's too late now.
It should be set up.
The microphones are in the correct channels.
Here's the problem. Now I can't hear anything.
I can't hear it. Now
you press a button. That's why.
Because this shouldn't be on. Because you've got buttons pressed here.
I didn't press that button. I swear to God. I swear to fucking God, Nick.
You're a godless heathen, Adam.
No, I take God seriously.
This shouldn't be on.
Yahweh.
That's how it should sound.
It does sound better.
That sounds better.
Yeah. So you're pressing buttons that shouldn't be pressed.
I'm not pressing buttons.
What did that do?
You put this on when you when you're using condenser mics.
Mm.
It sends phantom power to the mics. These are dynamic.
Phantom power.
These are dynamic mics.
I like the sound of that.
Well,
cool.
You know what I like the sound of, Adam? Is waking up in the morning, making a cup of coffee, getting my dick sucked by you, and then the board being set up correctly.
That's a cool sound.
I like the sound of that?
By the way, I saw a fat little Puerto Rican guy with huge balls the other day.
That's awesome. How'd you see his balls?
See him through his shorts.
That's so sick.
Yeah.
How little?
Probably like 5'1".
No, that's awesome.
Yeah, just like a very round, very snowman-y kind of guy.
With fat balls.
High top Air Force Ones. Just cruising. Lecturing an even smaller Puerto Rican guy.
Yeah.
I'm gonna tell you what, puppy. We're gonna go over there. And when we're over there, guess what we're gonna do? We're gonna come back over here. Like that. So
I love
that. Yeah, board plugged in wrong.
Yeah, this whole episode is a wash now. Thanks, Adam.
It might be, dude, because when you have this thing on, it blows out it sounds weird and shit. Hopefully the show isn't, all the episodes aren't uploaded wrong for the next couple of weeks.
Because of this.
Because of this.
This will be the reason.
Yeah. It could happen.
I did not press that button once again.
You did.
I swear to God Almighty. May he strike me down.
Stop invoking the name of God Almighty.
See, I just want to make sure that's because I need to know if I need to silence you where I'm doing it.
I said I'm in channel 3.
But the headphones you mess up. So everything is.
But they don't need to correspond. It's not.
They do need to correspond.
Why?
For specifically the reason that just happened.
Why?
Because he says I can't hear, and then I go like this.
Now I can't hear.
He can't hear anything. You know why?
What is that?
Because Adam plugged them into the wrong spot.
My God. The headphones don't correspond.
They do because it just happened. Let's start from the top.
Let's say I plugged my headphone in there.
You shouldn't press.
I didn't press that button.
You pressed this button.
Somebody pressed it, Adam. I've never touched the board in my life.
All right. Let's see. Let's. Hello?
That's another thing that you can do.
Hello?
Oh, that's interesting.
Yeah.
Hello? Okay, I'm back. Let's do a test, okay?
Uh-huh.
If I press...
Wow.
If I press that button...
You did.
Okay, what's the test?
May God give us a sign right now. Let's stay silent for 30 seconds.
Okay.
15 seconds.
A minute, 2 minutes.
2 minutes, maybe? I'll say 2 minutes.
You know, I kind of want to do this because I truly believe we will actually see a sign.
All right. All right. 2 minutes. Start the clock.
Ian and I were talking about AA, and I want to give myself up to a higher power myself. So
okay.
I think it's cool.
I already have it. It's already going.
Okay. No. Let's starting. We got to say starting now. You can't start it.
Okay.
All right.
And
starting now.
the hell is that?
That's fake, dude.
I'm not doing anything.
That doesn't prove anything.
What are you talking about?
Yeah, I don't. I'd have to say that does.
Oh my god! What the hell was that?
In the last minute too. It's a beautiful day outside,
beautiful
but
day,
there's
but
lightning
that thunder
going
clap
on.
Just happened.
Right at the last, and then we have just now.
Oh my god!
Right at 2 minutes. Weird that came through.
Exactly at 2 minutes.
Exactly at 2 minutes. A thunder
clap.
After the 2 minutes of silence, that if you're listening to the show and you're like, fuck this, remember it was Adam's idea. If you want to send angry emails, you send them to
you
him.
You can use the 37-second skip button on
you
your
You can also keep in mind that God used specifically this opportunity to reveal his existence to humanity.
This is the first documented...
In 2,000 years, it's been either Cumtown or Mexican ladies' toast.
Right, yeah, that's right. The breakfast of a maid.
That it has mm-hmm. its face, Jesus' face, on you know a shit they took or mm-hmm, mm-hmm. or something they had to clean.
And I think this is probably more... A more conclusive.
So that and proves it.
It proves that Adam touched the button.
And more importantly, it proves you touched the button.
Well, I mean, we can squabble about the button
no,
all day
we can't.
Long.
You said it. May God give us a sign. And he
but
sent
now
us
that
in a beautiful
I think
day.
That all humanity will unite behind one higher power, a Jewish God in the sky.
No.
That
no,
was
no,
the God
no,
that
no,
I was talking
no,
to.
No.
Now that we're all... Now that we're all Jewish.
Definitely not a Jewish
and
guy.
We're all making...
Did you know that the final solution came from a Ouija board?
I didn't.
Yeah. That Hitler,
Hitler
and
was
him,
playing...
He was having a sleepover?
And yeah, it was actually... They had a sign that they should do it. They didn't even want to. That all came up during Nuremberg. They were like, why'd you do this? And they were like, I don't know.
Yeah.
If we asked a magic eight ball.
Mm-hmm. And it says... Should we exterminate 6 million Jews? Yeah. 5 million gay
it
guys
all
and
answers,
gypsies.
All signs point to yes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Hermann Goering, he wanted to play the game where you find out who your husband is, whether you get in a mansion.
And
with,
oh, MASH. MASH. Yeah. No, they use the little four-corner folder thing.
Yeah. Oh,
we're
yeah,
doing the symbol with our hands, folks, but you know
yeah,
what we're
four
saying.
The four-corner. No, those things are cool. I want to make one.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
We should get into those in the cabin.
We should get into origami.
Absolutely.
Yeah, I'd love to.
I'm thinking about maybe doing a little Puzz 3D up there.
That sounds awesome.
Eiffel Tower.
You know what? A puzzle would be fucking sick.
I love puzzles.
We got to get a puzzle.
Yeah. We can get a puzzle.
But 3D puzzles.
Yeah, man. That's
fun. I had a dream my dad was mentally retarded and I had to take him to the Lego store. He was like...
It was just your dad's face. Everything was the same, or did he look a little?
I mean, he looked the same, but he was like dying of mental retardation.
Right.
I had
right.
to like take him to the Lego store.
Yeah.
And it made me sad.
Like to cure him or like for fun?
Just to make him happy one last time.
Right. Yeah. So he was fatally retarded.
Fatally retarded. Yeah. Terminally retarded.
That would be funny if it could be something that happens to you. Because I got to be honest.
If you can go dumb.
I gotta be honest.
I believe it's possible.
That's not bad.
Getting hit really hard in the head.
If
one
you
time.
Retire, and you're like, you know what, man, just make me retarded.
Mm-hmm.
I want candy. I don't want pussy anymore.
Mm-hmm.
I want the simple pleasures of life.
I want friends.
I want to hang out with my friends and be happy to see everyone.
Yeah, I don't want my family to ever leave me.
Exactly. I want to be hanging out with my mom until until she goes,
mm-hmm.
and then I want to be 60 years old and forget and be like, what happened?
Yeah, you know? It's truly a shame that people die, but it's also a shame that they have to experience their life. Mm-hmm. And the answer is mental retardation.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. It is the perfect solution.
We should make the retards live forever.
Absolutely.
Honestly, that would probably fix a lot of things.
Yep.
They get these mRNA vaccines and figure out a way to make retards live forever. They can't breed, so it's a net zero to...
That's right.
To you know, population.
Right. As we know, the sperm is also retarded.
Yeah, I know you're saying, what about their carbon footprint? Egg. And they can basically live off Oreos. Which
that's right.
A lot of people don't know this, but they're vegan.
They're vegan and they're zero emission.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They got different flavors of Oreos. Now they got candy corn Oreos.
No shit.
Oh, that sounds disgusting. The birthday cake Oreos. That's you know what? It's weird. I talked a s'mores
Oreo?
I got into an argument with SDB the other day. About the birthday cake. And they didn't believe.
Suck dick butt cheeks?
No, some dumb bitch.
Oh, some dumb bitch.
An STB.
An STB.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
About the birthday cake. And they're like, that's just any cake that's served on your birthday. And it's like, no.
Okay.
There's a type.
Okay.
It's a flavor.
Okay, Mrs. fucking semantics.
Yeah.
Suck me off. It's a fucking.
It's a type of cake. Really, it's confetti.
They think they're so smart.
Funfetti fucking. You know what I'm talking about. Yeah. It's a yellow cake with funfetti go throughout, white icing.
Yes, that's the traditional one. Or listen, it can be a sheet cake.
Yeah.
But
I don't know what the fuck.
Yellow,
I don't know what
it's
sheet
a yellow
cake,
cake
is.
Yellow funfetti is the traditional birthday cake. That's what's on the packaging.
Yeah.
That's the flavor.
Yeah.
But at the same time, it's not. Here's what it definitely isn't. It definitely isn't a carrot cake you have on your birthday.
Right.
It definitely isn't a fucking German chocolate cake you have on your birthday.
That's what I used to.
But.
Yeah, I feel like your grandma decides the German chocolate cake is your favorite, and then that's just
it's
your
not
birthday.
That good.
I had German chocolate cake. My mom or my grandma would make me German chocolate cake for my birthday because they decided that was my favorite. At one
yeah.
Time.
What the fuck is that?
I used to
because one time when you were
Duncan
three,
Hines
you had a bite and smiled.
Yeah.
And they're until you're fucking 17 years old, they're like, yeah, that's
no,
his
the
favorite.
Best cake is Italian cheesecake with a cigarette. That's a fucking birthday. I want a lit cigarette out of the top.
Yeah, and that's the,
and
that's
I,
the candle.
I smoke it from the top.
Oh, shit, dude.
Yeah.
Got the ember dancing on your tongue.
Mm-hmm.
There's a better cheesecake.
Uh-oh.
Shut up.
What is
Shut
it?
Shut up, dude.
Basque.
No, no one's going to ask you anything.
Spanish cheesecake.
That's not real.
The Basque do a
B-A-S-Q-E-U-E.
They do a different cheesecake. I had it
and
recently.
And what the fuck is it, Mr. Fucking International?
Look it up, dude.
It's like huevos rancheros, but cheesecake. It's got salsa in it. Salsa cheesecake.
Yeah.
I just got a text from my friend to RSVP to her wedding, but I'm like, I'm officiating.
You remember the first time you heard of like Mexican breakfast? You thought it was just racist?
Mm.
Or I did.
I don't remember that.
Yeah, I remember seeing Mexican breakfast somewhere, and it was just eggs with salsa and shit on it, and I'm like, come on.
Right.
This fuck, what's that, black people breakfast, and it's eggs with watermelon
right,
and fried chicken?
Right. And it's like, no, this is what Mexicans have.
Yeah, they literally eat that.
Yeah, huevos rancheros does feel like, come on, man.
Yeah, well, huevos rancheros, if it had been called that, that would make sense. But calling it Mexican breakfast, and it's just regular breakfast, but they threw some salsa on there?
Yeah.
You know what's really good for breakfast? Chilaquiles. Have you ever had that?
Why are you sitting like you're in labor?
I do hate how you're sitting right now.
It's just
you got your fucking pussy all the way out.
I hate it, dude.
What's
seriously
wrong with that?
No. Why are you doing this, man? You have some modesty.
You know I'm the most chaste member of the podcast.
Yeah, chaste Buttigieg.
Yeah.
No?
Chase a man's penis.
His name is Chasten.
Whatever. Their baby's name Chase or
something. And what's the deal now is like that so like they won't like women get paid time off, but now some gay
guys get
some gay murderer for the government is like, I need 2 years off. So me and my fucking they don't even have the kid yet.
I have no idea.
And how does that work?
Wait,
they
he
put
gets
it in
two
his
years
ass.
Off?
Huh?
Yeah, you have to put it in your ass to incubate it.
Yeah,
you have to finish it in your ass.
Right, yeah. It's like one of those dinosaurs that get bigger.
Yeah. You
that's what, yeah, Chasten is giving birth to one of those sponge dinosaurs.
Yeah. He's like, we are adopting the baby, but I wanted to know what motherhood felt like. So I put one of those little dinosaurs in my ass 9 months ago, and it's getting really big.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, dude. Fucking motherfucking Pete and Chasten.
Yeah. What's he do now? Secretary of something?
Secretary of Transportation.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Highways.
Mm-hmm.
Cruising.
Yeah. Truck stop.
Truck stop. He's going to start there.
Truck stop.
He started at the truck stop.
Yeah.
Like Fauci was like at gay bathhouses to check out AIDS.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Buttigieg is at the truck stops. Just
he's probably shutting them down.
Shutting
being a self-loathing.
As you know, we're currently doing this. This is we are here live right now in the second week of November. We're well into the Kyle Rittenhouse trial.
Yeah, we know. Right. And we can't. There's some crazy.
Dude, I was reading the news today.
Revelation.
I was reading to the news also.
Today on November 10th.
Yeah.
Whatever today is.
Mm-hmm.
It's definitely today. I know that.
It's today, and it's November 13th.
It's November 10th.
So that was a crazy surprise.
No. November 10th
yeah.
was Wednesday.
So when it's, we recorded, today is the...
Oh, you're right.
Today is November 13th.
Yeah. Yeah. November, which it definitely is that day. I'm just confused because I'm...
I'm sorry, November 14th.
I've been...
The 14th.
I'm... because I have diabetes.
Yep.
Which I was diagnosed with 2 weeks ago.
Yeah. That's what happened when you sucked on my dick one time. You caught it.
Yeah.
My nuts. You said yeah.
Yeah, in a way, again.
You keep doing shit like this.
It's like, yeah.
Where you say it.
Yeah, sure. Like sarcastic.
No. Yeah, you said yeah. Adam, back me up here.
Backing you up,
yeah,
buddy.
Thanks.
Always on your tail,
so,
buddy.
Adam, Nick or did he not just admit he sucked my dick and
what
caught
the
hell
I did one of those quick admits.
What the hell is this? 20 questions? That's my favorite when people say that. Were you cheating on me? What the hell is this, bitch? 20 questions?
What is it?
That's not even the game.
It's one question.
It's one question.
It's one question. It's like, did you eat your coworker's pussy?
Mm-hmm. It's just a dick suck.
Just a dick suck. It ain't cheating.
Yeah, but Kyle Rittenhouse, wild trial. Adam, you said there was that Adam, the surprise witness.
Which was who? Marilyn Manson.
Oh yeah. How did that go? Sort of.
I believe he testified that his music made Kyle do it.
Yeah, he said that.
And he took full responsibility.
Yeah, he said it's his bad, and that he actually did take his rib out to suck his own dick.
Let me ask you this, because
they were like, "Objection! Is relevance?" Yeah. And they're like, "I'll allow it." Marilyn, did you take that?
Do you think people would be mad at Kyle Rittenhouse if he didn't have like one of those like the like red wet lips and kind of a piglet aesthetic?
Yes. But I do. I don't think it helps.
I think they're going after him for his.
No, they're going after him for having a close relationship with his mother.
Right.
Which is a very unpopular thing to.
Does he have a close relationship?
I mean, didn't his mom drive him to kill people?
Yeah.
His mom gave him a ride.
I think his mom dropped
him
off.
To be honest with you, I didn't pay attention to anything. I watched the video, but only because I like videos of people shooting each other. I forgot to even make a judgment. I was just like, badass.
Right.
Awesome.
Yeah, right, you thought it was just like a video.
I thought
game.
It was sick. I mean, honestly, it is cool. That video is awesome.
I haven't watched
I don't
the
remember
video.
The video. I remember him walking past the cops and the cops not doing anything.
Well, the first part of the video, some guy's chasing him and then tries to take his gun and he shoots a guy. You can't really see anything. But in the second part of the video, there's like a mob after him. And one guy's like swinging a skateboard at him. He falls to the ground. And then another guy pulls a gun on
him. Jesus Christ.
And he's on the ground and he shoots the guy like through his elbow. And you see the guy's elbow fucking explode.
Whoa, jeez.
And I'm like,
fuck, dude.
That's cool.
That's cool.
That's cool.
I don't know, man. I prefer it to be stuntmen getting
Nick,
fake
Nick
shot.
Roots for the bad guys, you know?
Well, I just like violence in general. I'm not a bad guy. This has nothing to do with politics. I just like seeing people get hurt.
That's true.
You would have been just as happy if someone shot Kyle Rittenhouse in the head.
The internet was way better 10 years ago when it was just fighting videos. Mm-hmm.
That is true.
That was a much purer version of the internet.
It wasn't even 10 years ago, dude.
It was less than that, yeah.
No. I think longer.
You think longer?
I think so.
Do you remember bum fights?
Of course do I remember bum fights.
That was a product of my hometown, Las Vegas, Nevada.
Was it?
Yeah.
Bum fights was great. Kimbo Slice was great.
Yeah, Backyard. What is it?
And then they tried to make him an MMA guy.
My favorite part of Kimbo videos is when he beats the shit out of the guy and he's walking away and he just looks at the camera and he goes, gotta eat.
R.I.P.
Like, that's just, it's like, it's a living.
Yeah, yeah, he did die, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, he died.
What happened? His heart exploded or some shit?
I fucked him in his ass.
What?
I beat his ass, dude.
You fucked up Kimbo Slice?
Yeah, he was like, he's like, I got too much to lose. I can't get this one on video. And I just wrecked his shit, dude.
Really?
Yeah.
But it paid
and
really
nobody
well.
Fucking believes me.
But it paid well.
Nobody believes me. I beat the shit out of him.
That's awesome, dude.
Dude, that's I believe you, bro. That's really annoying that no one will believe
I beat his
you.
Ass so good he killed himself.
You shit. Didn't kill him, but you kind of did.
No, I batted him around like a cat
like a mouse.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Damn.
I was like, what's up?
Don't pop, pop, pop.
Let's we'll reenact the fight for the next 40 minutes. So it was like, pow, pow, choo, pow, 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 pow. I've never been in a fight, so I don't know what they sound like, really, but, you know, something like that. That was the one fight I've ever been in.
Yeah, he was 6'2",
mm-hmm.
235.
So we're like evenly matched.
I thought he was bigger than that.
Nah.
On the videos, he looked enormous.
What do you mean he thought he was bigger than
that? I thought it was like 6'5", 6'6".
That's big.
No. Damn, he died at 42 in Margate, Florida. And he was a Bahamian. He was a Bahamian man.
Yeah, I don't know how I remember that. I think he used to have like Bahamas flag stuff.
His real name was Kevin Ferguson.
Mm-hmm. That's a sick name.
Kimbo Slice is a great name, dude. Yeah. When's the last time you were in a fight, Adam?
Against a guy?
Yeah.
It's been ages.
Yeah. I don't think, I mean.
I remember Adam tried to tell me once, he tried to describe a fight he was in. As a drunk Mexican guy was like, give me your wallet, and Adam like brushed past him and ran away.
I elbowed him in the stomach.
Wow, dude.
But he was completely blackout drunk.
And he tried to fight you?
He was like literally teetering towards the ground.
And he tried to rob you?
It was a Salvadorian guy in Columbia Heights. I was leaving the Wonderland Ballroom.
Dude, that's how awesome. That guy thought he literally had a chance to rob you completely blacked out. Yeah. That's how non-intimidating you were. He was hoping you would just hand him your wallet and kind of steady him and let him on his way.
Yeah.
I would fight when I was a kid, but I haven't really gotten into fights as an adult. In elementary school, I think I told the story where I beat these two kids at ping pong, and then they just fucking were mad, and I was just talking shit. And I had beaten the other one of these kids up in a fight a couple years before. And I think they got their comeuppance. They just beat the shit out of me for being too good at ping pong.
Mm-hmm. Wow.
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
Joey Wright and Mike.
They ran up on you.
They fucking gave me a black eye, dude. And then I just had to see them at school. And then my dad fucking threatened these children from his van. That was like 11.
From his ice cream truck, you mean?
My dad was not an ice cream man. I wish he was.
That you would get picked up from school every day to an ice cream. How humiliating would that be?
Yeah.
Martin You're Amini. Fat as shit.
Martin Amini's dad had an ice cream.
Yeah, but Martin Amini's hot.
He's not hot. He's not fat.
Well, he's not, yeah, but he's not.
He's a good looking guy. No disrespect to Martin.
He looks good.
Yeah, he's not.
But he's not hot. Well, he's wow, Nick wants to fuck Martin Amini.
Yeah, Nick has Martin.
I haven't really thought about it.
Oh, Nick, wow, Nick likes a half Bolivian, half Iranian.
First, you fucking sucked my cock and got diabetes. Now you want to fuck Martin.
It's
dude.
All coming out.
This is kind of reckless lip smacking Kimbo Slice was doing before he caught these fucking hands.
Shit, dude. Don't fuck
this
me.
Kimbo Slice was teasing.
Kimbo was saying you're gay, and that's why you fought him.
Kimbo was like, you know, really wanted to have a day out at the park on my behalf.
Wow.
And I said, you watch yourself.
You better check yourself, he Kimbo. Didn't.
And that is rude.
Zip, zip, zip. Pop, 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 pop.
Ba da ba da.
Yeah.
Whoop.
Ding, boom, boom. Yeah, it would be tough to be a fat child getting picked up. Like, ice cream truck. I don't know anything else worse. It would be humiliating to get picked up in like a domino with your if your dad picked you up with like the little dominoes thing.
Mm-hmm.
No, that's more about poverty than
that's
it is
probably
being
worse
fat.
Than.
Yeah, I hope I wouldn't have a lot. I would have just make ridiculous amounts of money so that like if my son misbehaves at home, I can pick him up from school the next day, get a work van.
Mm-hmm.
While he's at school, he has no idea. Get a work van, ladder on top,
right?
Everything. And on the side, just decal that says, "My son is gay construction, LLC." And then just, bah, 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 I'm here to pick you up from school.
Jeremy.
Yeah. Yeah, 6th, 7th grade, right in the money spot.
I'm 6th. Oh, yeah. 7th is the worst.
Like, what are you doing?
It's my like, son is gay construction.
That's what you get for recklessly lip smacking.
That's what you get for playing with my fucking
my
Legos.
My son just looks exactly like Kimbo Slice.
He's got
to
eat.
Yeah, time to go home to mom, who looks nothing like Kimbo Slice.
Yeah.
I And I guess you got the maybe some of his DNA rubbed off when I
when
beat, his
beat his ass. Yeah, yeah. My son's black because I fucked up this black guy years ago.
Because I beat his ass.
I beat up black guy about 30 years ago, and now you know how it mixes in. And that's my son is black now.
Yeah, just explaining that on Shark Tank, and they're like, "What's your business?" And you're like, "Business." I thought this was just a show where you come explain things. Explain things to rich who can catch these hands. Let's say fucking acknowledge.
Yeah, don't look at me, Damon.
Yeah, you remind me of a one time that I had a problem with.
Everyone's like, "Whoa, whoa, what the fuck?" Barbara Corcoran's like, "You can't say that."
I feel like Barbara gets fucked.
She got fucked back in the day.
I feel like she's
when
still
she talked
does.
About being a waitress, and I'm thinking, damn, let
that's,
me get some.
That's
pussy.
The Joanne Fabrics bitch on Shark Tank. Right?
Yeah, Barbara's got a vibe where she's still catching it.
Yeah, she's still sucking cock.
Yeah,
even though she's you know past that, she's doing it for her enjoyment.
I'd rather smash with Barbara than Lori.
No, I'd want to fuck Lori.
No, Lori'd be annoying.
Yeah, but she's a little hotter.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. It's like, I'd say Barbara's less attractive, but I'd rather smash with her.
Barbara's got that fucking little fucking German boy haircut.
Yeah,
let's do Barbara Corcoran.
That's kind of just like a Midwest mom haircut.
Barbara Corcoran Young. Okay. She looks all right.
I think she's the Corcoran group. I think all those like...
No shit.
Yeah, they're like... Fucking real estate thing. I think that's her.
Oh, really? No, yeah. Doesn't she do restaurants or some shit?
No, I think she's real estate.
Anyway, what, man, Barbara. I'm seeing a picture of Barbara without her fucking all that TV makeup, and I'm out.
Really? Yes. Let me see.
And for this, I'm out. Because you, Barbara, you're an old wrinkly bitch, and for this reason, I'm out.
Yeah, you're on Dick Tank.
You're on Cock Tank, whore.
Yeah, welcome to fucking Cock Tank.
Oh, fuck.
You know, I think about it, and for the simple fact that there's the pussy, but there's also the booty hole, and then there's the titties. We call this the triumvirate of the pussy
the
temple.
Pussy triumvirate.
And if you don't have all three aspects of your shit integrated, then I'm out.
Yep.
That's yes. It's that simple. Either I'm in or I'm out.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
And once I'm out, I can't get back in unless my dick becomes hard. That's the only way in. It's not going in soft.
Yeah.
So you can suck dick.
Right.
You know, you can make up with it with the head game if you're missing part of the triumvirate.
That's right.
Or if you got the triumvirate, the head game still can't be sloppy.
Absolutely.
You see what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
Do you understand what I'm saying?
Yes.
Get the fuck off my show, bitch.
Yeah, sure.
Get off my show, bitch.
With your deflated titties.
Suck on my dick, bitch. Get the fuck off my show. Get the fuck off my show.
Apparently, Barbara Corcoran claims she was in a business meeting with Donald Trump.
Hold on now. From the back?
Yeah, she looks pretty good from the back, actually.
Barbara, why don't you come back in here? But back up, bitch.
Do a back pedal.
Back up, bitch.
Yeah. Beep, beep, beep. She said she was never in a room with him alone except on one occasion. She was pregnant at the time. And so he compared her breast size to his wife by putting his hands in the air.
That's awesome.
And
who did that, Donald Trump?
Donald Trump.
He's awesome.
Yeah, I'm definitely fucking Lori Griner, if you ask me. I'm looking at her Instagram right now.
Lori?
Yeah.
Something about her fucking annoys me.
Of course, but that would be all the more reason to
fuck
her.
Oh, yeah, Barbara does, is kind of, she has, like, nice legs from the back.
Yeah, dude. Yeah. Maybe it's time to start fucking old ladies.
Dude, that's
have you fucked an old lady, Adam? It seems like you randomly would have.
There was a guy.
You found some old lady on the street one day.
Fucked. There was a guy. Remember we were.
Have you fucked an old lady?
No, no.
The story starts. There was a guy.
No, when Nick and I were working at that fabrication shop. That guy Jesse. You remember that guy Jesse?
Shut up! You fucked an old man.
No. I didn't fuck an old man. Do you remember he was telling us? He's like, yeah, dude, I've been going to fucking cougar bars in Midtown.
Mm.
And he said there are like a couple bars on like the Upper East Side in Midtown that he goes to, and he just
really
and he fucks like 60-year-old women.
Should we go?
50? I feel like
Will
I was
you guys
like,
come wingman me.
I would love to go.
Yeah,
that'd be so fun.
I'm trying to get sucked off by an aspiring Real Housewife.
Yeah, exactly.
That'd be sick.
Those chicks are horny.
There was a woman.
I fucked a 40-year-old when I was 20.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah. What was his name?
Very nice. When I first moved, I fucked a 37-year-old, but I was 26. I remember that story. Yeah.
I remember that story of yours.
Yeah, yeah.
I don't remember that story.
That was, I believe, that might have been the first squirter I encountered. I ate that woman's pussy for so long.
For 36 years.
Yeah. and then she let me raw dog, and then just never, we mutually ghosted each other.
Mm.
But she had some big fat titties. It's pretty fun.
Yeah.
We got high. We were going to go watch Captain America, but then I just got pussy instead.
Topton America.
Topton.
Mm-hmm.
That's a cool name for your like British son that you bring on Shark Tank.
Topton.
I'm Topton, and I invented a new way to suck dick. You're like holding, you have your hand in your son's back pocket while he talks to the sharks. You know, we don't really get into Shark Tank enough on this show, but that really is very easy to just live in the world of Shark Tank jokes.
Mm-hmm.
This could just be a Shark Tank show.
You know who loves Shark Tank is Eldis.
Yeah.
Eldis watches Shark Tank.
He's got
constantly.
An entrepreneurial mind.
Mm-hmm. He does. Dude,
he has an entrepreneurial like outlook on things.
One time Eldis he was like, I'm going to start making my own soaps. And what he did was he bought soap and he put like a little bit of like lavender essential oil in it. And he said he was making soap. And he sold like one thing to like a family friend. And then he just like took the L on. I mean, that was his whole business, was fucking buying pre-made soap and putting a little bit of oil in it.
That's hilarious.
And he was like, yeah, he was talking.
It's like
about
less involved than even making fucking lemonade.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's more work.
This is a lemonade stand. I got lemonade and I'm adding sugar to it.
I think it was literally, I think he had that idea literally because of Shark Tank. He loves Shark Tank.
Mm-hmm.
I'm more of a Chopped guy. That's the kind of shit I like to fucking watch in the mm-hmm. background.
Yeah.
But you need something with a nice formula, you know?
Yeah.
Something your brain can relax.
Yeah, three eliminations. Nice. Breakfast, lunch, and dinner. What do they do? Appetizer, main,
yes.
And dessert. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Come on. You're sounding ridiculous now.
I don't watch too much Chopped.
I'm going to have a cooking show called Biggest Noodle.
Okay.
Where they have to make the biggest noodle.
That'd be cool.
And the winner gets to suck me off.
That would be awesome. Or they make a noodle that looks a lot like a cock,
mm-hmm.
and it's in a lineup, and they suck all three,
mm-hmm.
and they have to say which one was the cock.
I want to do this.
Which ones were the noodles?
It's like Chopped, but you're allowed to throw knives at the other chefs.
I like that
a
lot.
Cool.
Yeah,
there should be more danger.
It's called Knife Chef.
Knife Chef.
Yeah.
Or Chopped off your cock.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Or
Chopped your tits off.
Or Fox's Man versus Beast, but it's Chopped. So you have to be better at cooking than a chimpanzee.
Mm-hmm.
But the chimpanzee's allowed to beat you to death.
So you have to be its friend.
Mm-hmm.
You have to win the chimp over.
Mm-hmm.
Dude, I would not want to be in a fucking area with an unsupervised chimp.
An uncircumcised chimpanzee?
Yeah. Yeah.
They calm down if you circumcise them.
Interesting.
They do.
You got to shave it. You ever see one without its fur?
No.
A chimp?
Remember that picture? Yeah. They're insane.
Oh, yeah. I have seen that. It looks weird. It looks like a jacked old man.
Yeah. That's literally what I would love to look like.
A hairless chimp?
Yeah, like that. If that was
me.
Just, you know.
That is weird how fucking jacked they are.
Being like, hey, guys.
They walk
on
their hands.
God damn. That boy is fucking serious.
Mm-hmm.
That boy not fucking around, man.
Mm-hmm.
All right, what's our Shark Tank
that
idea?
Boy
chimp
to
make you chimp fit?
Yeah, chimp fit. Yeah.
Chimp fit.
Just sitting around like that.
Damn, dude. Why has he got his hair off?
He's chilling. They lose their hair in the summer.
Really?
Yeah, to have sex. They have to take their fur off.
They wax their pussies to have sex?
Yeah.
Dude, what would you do if you saw a fucking gorilla in the zoo and it was hairy but it had his pussy waxed?
He's wearing a thong.
Yeah, he's a slut.
Mm-hmm.
It's a girl.
Just like the head of the zoo getting fired because to like recognize trans people, he puts all the chimpanzees in dresses and in makeup and stuff. They're like, it's LGBT awareness at the Bronx Zoo, and we have all the tigers dressed up like girls.
So we put
just a tiger with lipstick on.
So we put smeared lipstick.
in like a pantsuit. Yeah. Some Hillary Clinton ass tiger. Trying to like wiggle out of the fucking. Like when you put a garbage on top of a cat and doesn't know whether to go back or forward.
Mm. I do like the tigers behave like cat, like little cats. Like all big ass cats. They all love
boxes.
Yeah,
they're all one family.
Mm-hmm. It's fucking hilarious when you see a fucking lion in a little ass box.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Saudi Arabians like owning them as cats.
I wouldn't have the guts. They could smell the fear on me.
Yeah.
But then again, I didn't have the guts to do 9/11 either.
Yeah. Yeah, they do. They love boxes.
That's awesome. You see a cat in a fucking like big ass box. Fucking tiger.
What happened to that guy, the Tiger King?
He's in jail still.
Ugh.
He's in jail. You think
Watch that.
You didn't?
No.
How the fuck did you watch it?
Because
the pandemic just started. There's nothing to do.
I was dealing with some other stuff at the time.
Oh, that's true.
Wait, what happened?
He was fucking in Vegas, dude.
I was in Vegas.
Gambling? Oh, yeah. You're gambling.
Attention. Yeah, I was gambling. I was doing
he was gambling
through
the pandemic.
This is good content now. Hold on here. Lions and tigers sitting
I'm telling
in
you,
boxes.
Bro.
Honestly, to be honest with you, this is new to me.
This is new to you? Oh, you're in videos. For a fucking treat, dude. These are the best videos on the internet.
We're going to have to cancel the show.
A big ass fucking lion getting in a box. It's so cute.
I love this shit, dude. I love big cats. You know, I'm a big conservation guy. I go to Africa every year and I shoot black people trying to kill them. I do. That's called reverse poaching.
Reverse poaching. You shoot the poachers.
I'm Antifa.
Right.
You know, I do. And I consider poaching a form of fascism.
Right.
So I go to Africa to kill black pirates. Well,
you guys want to come with me to Cape Town?
No.
Meet
no,
the Tupac
no,
of Cape
nope.
Town.
And then we'll, go, I will go.
And then we'll go.
I will
on safari.
Go separate the week after you leave.
Why?
And then you'll go the same time, but stay in
we'll
a completely
to,
different part of Cape Town.
We'll go to Kruger Park. We'll go on a safari.
Freddy Krueger Park.
Cruiser Park.
Kruger Park. We'll get the five. We'll you got to see the big five.
My dick?
No, it's...
That's what I call my dick.
No, it's the five...
The big five.
The five animals. The five animals you have to see before you leave.
What are they?
I don't know. I forget now.
When are you going?
Adam likes to do is he goes there and he gets a peacock to put its feathers in his ass and then spread them out.
Mm. You do like that?
Yeah.
Hold your phone if you agree that you like that. Well, there we go.
It's a lion, an elephant, a rhinoceros. What is that? A wildebeest?
A hippo?
Or like a water buffalo? And a leopard.
Okay.
You got to see them.
How far is South Africa?
It's pretty far. It's not as far as Australia.
What's the flight?
From New York, it's like 9 hours.
Oh, that's not bad.
Yeah, it's not bad.
That's a little... It's basically Greece.
Yeah, it's just you go south. I think maybe it's 10. I don't know.
This is the music to the cats sitting in boxes, by the way, everyone.
It's Andre and Arthur, the two Bengal tigers sitting in a box.
Are you going, Adam? Are you going to
South Africa? My grandma's 90. I gotta go see her. She's been in fucking COVID for the last 2 years. I feel bad about it.
Yeah, my grandma's 90. She's turning 91 December.
Sounds so lonely. I guess she has a brother.
My grandma's with my mom.
Yeah.
Dude, they got a nice little setup going there. Shit, I actually have to fucking... God damn it, dude. There's so much to do.
I know, dude. The holidays coming up.
I told my mom I would fuck... I gotta buy them a couch. They have basically like a little clubhouse where my mom and my grandma hang out and watch Greek TV.
Like outside the house?
No, like upstairs. They took George's old room. When COVID happened and my dad wasn't... Yeah. He was just like still going
they
out.
They made
like,
a gal cave.
He was like playing... He was just like hanging out and drinking... And like fucking with the
drinking
boys.
Drinking cheap Lambrusco wine in the Giannacolo Hill over
there. Him and just all his fucking construction worker, day laborer ass fucking contractor friends would still go to coffee houses. Like
it is very funny to force day laborers to hang out with you.
Yeah.
Part of the day rate.
Yeah. Well, just other Greeks, I guess contractors.
I thought you meant like Juan Carlos.
Yeah, he would buy them to be friends.
That would be so funny.
The social dynamic of those guys is, I know I've said it before, but I love it. And there's always one that's drunker and more aggressive than the rest.
Yeah, you can tell he's the pack alpha pack leader.
And he just never gets his work.
Yeah.
Like you, and you. And yeah. The aggressive guy with the backwards hat and the Spider-Man backpack just stays in the parking lot drinking.
Probably happy on some level.
Damn. Look at that.
What the hell is that?
Angled directly at the piece of a wire brush.
Oh my god! And it's almost twice as big as your dick.
Almost.
And it would have completely sabotaged it.
By almost, it's not. Did you see that by the AOC tweet where she's like, almost 10 people died at the Capitol?
What?
Yeah, she's talking about January 6th.
So that's just not true.
Yeah, it's not true. Well, I guess it's true. It depends.
One person got shot by the cops.
One person got shot by the cops, and then that's
someone
it.
Had a heart attack later.
Yeah, like 2 days later. But I guess that's almost 10.
It's almost 10. Yeah. Someone tasered himself, or that was fake, right?
I guess you can say you can qualify anything with almost.
My dick is almost 10 inches.
Yeah.
Almost 10 people.
I almost fucked AOC 10 times.
You know what? I almost fucked
zero is close to 10, but I almost that's almost
zero. Nearly zero. Is better than almost.
Yeah,
nearly because zero is near.
Basically 10. Is the best of all.
Yeah,
of
I basically fucked her 10 times. basically is the funniest one because it's clearly the biggest lie. Yeah. Basically, it's like no one who's telling the truth would use basically ever.
Yeah. But I did. I basically
I actually did, though.
You didn't.
I did.
I basically fucked her.
I, for the most part, fucked her in the pussy.
Mm-hmm. as long as we're spitballing here, I fucked her 10 times.
Nah, I fucked her more than that.
Yeah. And for and lack of a lack you. Of a better word, I fucked AOC 10 times.
Fuck my ass. Oh, baby, I wanna suck.
Ooh, baby, I'm fucking gay.
I'm fucking gay.
I'm fucking gay.
Ooh, I want you to watch me be gay.
I wanna suck at you love all day.
Fellas, is it gay to force a bitch to watch you fuck a man? No. Because that's what's making you getting off to making the bitch.
It's yeah.
You're trying to get her horny.
My ass is juicing up because I'm thinking about
coming up on cock
what's
tank.
Going on with her pussy. Coming up on cock tank. It's a mix of trying to allow women to suck your cock or figuring out scenarios that are gay and not gay.
Mm-hmm. Right.
So you notice you're clear of them. That's a good service we could provide with Cock Tank.
I think so. I think it's a great idea.
Mm-hmm. Your tits aren't that big, but there's something about your mouth and the one fucked up tooth that's really doing it for me. And for that reason, I'm in.
The Snaggletooth?
Yeah.
Shout out to the Snaggletooth whores.
Shout out to the Snaggletooth whores out there.
Yeah, some of the hearts of gold, honestly. The Snaggletooth.
No, it's one of those things where it's like it barely is a dent in your attractiveness or whatever.
No, you know what I mean? It's cuter.
Yeah, exactly.
Somebody with you want.
It's not like they're missing a fucking arm. It's just like your one tooth is.
I'll fuck a bitch with no arm, no problem.
Yeah, I've done it.
Really?
Well, not missing an arm, but weird limb deformity.
Nice. Hell yeah, respect. Damn, now I'm jealous. I've never done that. If you're missing an arm and you want to suck me off out there, holler at me.
Mm-hmm.
Adam, have you ever fucked somebody missing a limb of any kind?
I wish.
Damn. We're not even living, dude.
We think we've had so much experience. We think we're so worldly.
But we haven't even been to Monte Carlo.
We haven't been
to Monte Carlo.
We haven't been in a high
How
stakes.
How far is Monte Carlo?
We haven't been in a high stakes poker
about
200, game.
250 miles.
With a guy with an eye patch.
Bitch, you wouldn't even believe me if I told you.
Monte Carlo, it's like between Italy and France, no?
Oh. What is that like? Between Italy and France?
Is that right?
What is that like being young and naive?
What is that? Is that like in the south of France?
I don't fucking know. Isn't it like a big tax, like rich people?
Yeah,
there?
It's like one of those tiny city-state countries.
I want to take my dad to Monte Carlo.
Oh,
now
really?
Now that he's dying.
To watch the race?
That's your dream, Nick. That's your dream. It's not real life.
Oh.
Yeah.
Sometimes it's hard to tell.
Monte Carlo is officially... it's in Monaco. Monte Carlo.
Yeah, Monaco is the state.
Yeah, I don't know where the fuck this is. Oh, like Switzerland, France, Italy. Yeah, I guess you're right, between Italy and France. Damn. Now, we got to go to Puerto Rico in January. I know we haven't left for the cabin yet, but I'm ready for our next vacation. I want to go somewhere warm in January. I'm skipping the whole winter, dude.
I'd be down with Puerto Rico or Miami, honestly.
Charterico.
Miami's good, but will it be hot?
Yeah, it'll be hot. And we can go see NBA, dude. We'll go watch Jimmy Butler.
That's actually a great idea.
Dude, Miami's the best city
in America.
First
week in January, let's go to Miami.
I'm on the record as saying it's the best city in America.
Really? I've never been to Miami just because it seems like...
Let's go.
It's sick.
It seems like it sucks. Like, dude, in the same way that Vegas sucks.
You know how, like, you live in New York and you know someone for years and they, like, dress like shit and stuff and then you find out, like, after knowing them for years, they're, like, a billionaire scion?
No, this is you.
Can I get...
What are you looking at?
How dare you point?
Can you pass me that coffee?
I'm honestly, I am a little taken aback by that.
Anyway, but in Miami, it's like...
Who do you think you are?
You just get up and point. As if I'm gonna just fucking do it.
All right, I was gonna go on my Miami rant.
Yeah, he thought he was getting ready to give a speech.
It really felt that way. It felt like you were.
No,
fucking...
I didn't. No, I just wanted to get up and get my coffee.
You know how you know somebody and they dress like shit, yeah, but then they turn.
You
like,
pointing your coffee
time, all the time,
dude. He was getting his fucking. He was getting his, like, he was really dialing up towards something, and you're feeling yourself, yeah, and you're like, you know what? My energy is so high right now. I can point to my coffee and Stav will give it to
all
me.
Your friends are fucking trust fund 22-year-olds.
That's not true.
No, we don't have experiences like this.
No.
I don't know.
There are plenty of people like in New York City who
my friends are
you
the,
would walk past you
my
on
friends
the street.
Are the mentally retarded
listen,
man from
listen,
the grocery
would walk
store.
Past you on the street and then
the Haitian guy that I argue with about batteries.
And that guy could be worth a couple billion
not.
Dollars.
I know he's not.
How do you know? You haven't
he's
asked.
Got it, he's I've got she's got a
I'm just saying, listen.
The woman that owns the flower
right,
shop.
I'm not
going to
finish my rant.
Window.
Yeah. Ran over.
No, I'm interested. I'm interested. Go ahead.
I'm not saying that. Listen, even if you know them for 2 years and you find out they're rich, you walk past people all the time that you wouldn't know are incredibly wealthy in New York. But in Miami, people wear their wealth like as like a mark of pride.
Right.
And the style there...
Damn, it's
like
listening to David Foster Wallace do one of his famous magazine essays.
Thank you. And the style there that they have.
Do they have lobsters there or tennis?
Mm-hmm. What do you mean?
I'm
sure they have both.
David Foster Wallace ran.
No, but in Miami, the swag is like 5 to 10 years.
There's a tactile sense of the wealth.
No, people are like...
You can see it. They wear their wealth. Unlike New York, where all the rich people look like bums.
Yeah, that's what's cool in New York.
Which is true. Which is definitely true.
It's not 100%.
There's no visible wealth in New York.
No, it's not 1,000% true.
There's none of it, but in Miami.
But in Miami, people are fucking...
The class distinctions aren't shied away from as such.
Right.
Well, no, it's just... It's
this is Evenings with Adam.
God damn it, dude.
Adam's Society Hour.
I assume that means that you think I'm saying smart shit right now.
The Society.
Yeah, for sure. That's
and then
what
their
it means.
Swag, their swag, like, their swag is 5 to 10 years in the past.
Listen, like, I'm interested in Miami.
It's just
only
it's such a different world there.
I'm interested because it's fucking warm and there's beaches.
And it's warm as hell, and you get off a flight in December in New York, and it's fucking 10 degrees here.
Yeah.
And it's fucking 70 over there.
Yeah. I'm down for anywhere where it's 70. We should go in January. And
well,
record.
I kind of want to go somewhere. I mean, it's not for winter, but somewhere I haven't. I've never been to Maine.
Okay.
And Maine's supposed to be beautiful.
Yeah. Dude, listen, the rest of this podcast is going to be a vacation podcast. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So we go
Maine's
somewhere
probably
in January.
Cold as shit, though.
Maine is
Maine in January doesn't sound...
No, Maine, what about Maine like spring, like April?
Well, how do you feel about the Southwest?
I'm in.
Would you ever go to like the middle, like Death Valley?
What do you mean?
Think about
like
it.
Just vacation?
Out in the desert, yeah, just somewhere in the middle of nowhere.
I mean, wait, it's like 130 degrees there during the summer.
It's January.
Oh, I mean, we can go to Palm Springs.
That's like the desert, isn't it?
That's like the desert.
Yeah, I'd do some shit like
I've only ever driven through all that shit.
I went to Death Valley. I used to go with my family growing up because there was a week where flowers, like, grow out of the desert.
And you were gay and you loved flowers.
And I would run around the flowers.
You would pick them?
Yeah.
Pick them.
For
my
Valentine's
dad would tell
Day.
Me to stop skipping. Mm-hmm. And I'd say, I'll never stop.
Yeah, dude. I'm just trying to go somewhere hot. Trying to go somewhere hot in the winter time. Because listen, winter until Christmas is nice. Mm-hmm. After Christmas, yeah. I don't want winter.
Yeah, you're absolutely right.
And
yeah.
it's got to. It's
and
I
apparently
to feel
there's
like the
a
holidays.
Tax credit for any podcast that moves down to Florida.
Oh well, there we go.
If you say the N word enough times, you get enough. Of They're trying to
high score. Dude, it would be funny if we got some kind of podcasting tax credit. if we moved to like
they
want to
attract podcasters.
They
want
to attract podcasters to their fucking community.
Miami is an incubator of podcast minds.
I would love that, dude. Oh my God, my pussy is small. I want to suck your dick and fuck your balls.
We can go to like a mega club one night, get
no,
bottle service.
We're not doing that.
Why not?
Maybe one time.
Yeah, one time.
But I don't know. Even that sounds.
We go to space. I went to space in Miami.
What space?
It's like a mega club.
Maybe we fuck. Listen, maybe we get some high end Cubano whores.
Some high end Cuban whores. We'll make them roll cigars in their pussies for us. You know what I?
Would
you know
you guys I, watch me fuck a?
Hey, what do you think about
sexy?
What do you think about this
prostitute?
Plan? What do you think about
I'm
this?
I'm listening.
Yeah,
I spent $30,000 on a grandfather clock.
I love that.
Yeah,
it would go with this
right
room.
Here.
Yeah, it'd be
perfect.
Nice.
Would tick tock?
How loud would the thing be every hour?
Definitely. Very loud.
Incredibly loud.
I go, welcome to my
the
my
building
ass.
Would shake.
Dong. Welcome to my ass.
Yeah, dude, you do need a grandfather clock.
I need shit on the walls.
That's true.
We need some kind of taxidermy up here. Or that
ooh,
fucking...
The sword.
The sword and the shield.
The sword and
thing.
The shield up there.
With the chains hanging
yeah.
down.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
A lot
yeah.
of red wax. That'd be
yeah,
cool.
Yeah,
candles.
That would
I should get a little
sick.
Organ for over there.
Yes, sir.
I don't know how to play organ, though.
That doesn't matter.
You can figure that out. Yeah.
Yeah, you need something. It's just like the... If they were completely blank walls, it would let you play around with it a little more.
Mm-hmm.
Because you got to work around the molding.
Yeah. I should get some portraiture.
That would be nice.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
That would be fucking sick.
Yeah. Just yeah, all those, like, fucked up inbred Spanish royalty from...
Yeah. What if they had just the... Their faces are fucked up. What if they had the nicest cocks?
Probably. They're retarded.
The Habsburgs. You're
yeah.
right.
Yeah, they got
they probably had
thing.
Heavy nuts. Although, actually, didn't they say they didn't fuck or something like that? Or they were like...
Well, they were... I don't know. They couldn't feed themselves, I think, at a certain point. And it wasn't because they were rich.
That shit is so funny. I'm going to look up Habsburg penis.
Habsburg penis. I'm going to watch more videos of cheetahs playing with cardboard boxes.
Dude, it's the best.
What the fuck is verba?
The Spanish urological problems of Charles II. fuck. Let's see what this says. Looked at discovery and spread of syphilis in the
yo,
world.
I should mention this. I rewatched Dumb and Dumber the other night.
Did it hit?
Yeah, it's funny, but I forgot how good the soundtrack is.
Oh, really?
Oh, I can't even recall. Yeah. I haven't seen it in so long.
You should pull it up.
Throughout his childhood, he was extremely fragile and developmentally challenged. Intellectually stunted, his 30-year rule was ineffective. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Despite being married twice, Charles produced no offspring. A rudimentary autopsy with the following results. A very small heart, lungs corroded, intestines putrefactive and gangrenous, 3 large stones in the kidney, a single testicle black as coal, and his head full of water. This man was literally a waterhead.
So he died at 45?
We can, I don't know. We can conclude that Carlos suffered from posterior hypospadias, monarchism and an atrophic testicle. So he probably had an intersexual state with ambiguous genitalia
wow.
and a congenital monokidney with stones and infections.
Oh, he was the...
We're just going to do the Dumb and Dumber soundtrack for the rest
Dumb
of the show.
Dumb and Dumber, it's a good song.
Great song.
If you don't, maybe suicide. It's my love that'll kill me, dear. If you won't hold me and have me near, don't you fret.
about.
Yeah, if you don't love me, I'll kill myself. Yeah, if you don't love me, I'll kill myself.
That's a great sentiment.
Yeah, if you don't love me, I'll kill myself. Chiller needs a breeze. I need you more than an Eskimo freeze. I need your loving more than money or air. If you don't love me, baby, that's not fair. Cause I'll be good to you in every way. I'll give you loving, baby, every day. A loving that's good, a loving that's alright. A loving like you're loving on the coldest night.
Song,
yeah, certainly a lot better than doing the podcast.
Yeah, well, who was that?
It's
the Bare Naked Ladies.
Yeah, it's the Bare Naked. It's the Bare Naked Guys.
What?
That's yuck.
Adam's
that's
favorite
Adam's
band.
Favorite band. No.
Dude, that band name was so confusing when you find out it's all guys.
Dude, fucking, I'm the kind of guy that gets his little dick signed.
They should have.
Yeah, you know, some other stuff. Like
all right,
that.
I guess we'll do one more bit and then this motherfucker.
And if you don't suck me, I'll fuck myself.
I mistimed that. I thought that would carry us into an hour. We got a minute.
Well, we got a minute. We have now 54 seconds.
Yeah.
So
we'll do a quick recap of the movie Garfield, A Tale of Two Kitties.
Okay. I've never seen it. What happens?
Can we watch it?
Yeah, we can. I'll just we'll go ahead and play the trailer.
Let's just play the trailer for the and take your time, by the way, because you know the longer it takes. If you don't suck me, I'll
Adam,
suck
what's going
myself.
On with the boy? Why don't you tell us about?
Is Kyle Rittenhouse?
No, what? Yeah, Kyle Rittenhouse, or
what about?
Or maybe you can like try to humble brag about something, and we can chew your ass out over it.
Mm-hmm. Well, a lot of people say I'm an empath.
Yeah. A lot of people say that.
You know, I saw that movie Dune recently.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of people have been coming up to me and telling me that they'd love to see me play Timothy Chalamet's
no they haven't
mom.
Older brother
best friend or older brother. Yeah.
A lot of people have said that to me and I don't know.
Best friend or older brother?
Yeah. I don't know if I'm
you know, I wanted to see that, but I tell you that
I watched it. It was sick.
The advertising campaign was too aggressive, and my oppositional defiance disorder.
You didn't like being told what to do.
Yeah, I felt it was too much. It was like you got to watch Dune. I'm like, you can tell me
fuck
what to
you.
Do, motherfucker.
Is that what the
that's why I don't have health insurance?
The movie trailer said you got to watch this movie.
Yeah, there was. Well, you know, I mean,
isn't that the point of you know?
Yeah, but I, you know. Yeah, you know, I do things my way.
Oh, you know what we could say right for the last 10 seconds of the podcast?
What?
I would like to thank you for the cheeses and crackers that you gave me for breakfast, Nick.
Oh, yeah, of course.
And the potatoes.
Well, though. Adam, you gave me your garbage. You gave me your cold
the
garbage.
The way you would feed a pig trash.
Exactly. Whereas my friend Nick laid out a night. He saw how distressed I was that you came through with a bag. And it didn't have stuff for everybody in it.
Nothing for everybody.
And okay. What Nick did.
You showed up late and you're like, I can't find parking. As if you haven't driven here
every
you don't
day
live in
for
Brooklyn.
Once a week.
You
there
know
wasn't parking today.
And where did you park?
On the next block over.
Oh, okay. So there was parking.
Well, I found parking eventually.
You found
that's
parking
why I'm
a
here.
Block away.
So 2 years after the events of the first film, John Arbuckle plans to propose to his girlfriend, veterinarian Dr. Elizabeth Wilson.
Damn, so he's marrying a bitch that done work on his pussy.
Who,
that's right.
Tunes who's his pussy going, up. Yeah. Who is
cut
going
Garfield's balls off. Imagine that, Garfield, you get your nuts cut off so and then pissed. The doctor that did
the
it.
The bitch just lives in your house.
Yeah. So basically, she's going on a business trip, a veterinarian business trip to London. Mm. John follows Liz to the United Kingdom as a surprise after escaping from a kennel. John's two pets, Garfield and Odie, sneak onto John's luggage and join him on the trip. Garfield and Odie break out of the hotel room due to boredom and subsequently get lost in the streets of London.
Wow.
Meanwhile, Adam's at Carlisle
in his
Castle.
Eatfield and Lodi. Because yeah, he yeah. eats loads.
All right.
That's true.
Eatfield.
Eatfield and Lodi. Yeah. Well. Meanwhile, at Carlisle Castle in the English
John
countryside,
R-Wordle.
The lady Eleanor Carlisle...
Hard Arbuckle.
Is
this a black John Arbuckle?
Yeah.
Her will is read by the solicitors, Mr. Hobbs, Mr. Green, and Mr. Whitney. She bequeaths Carlisle Castle to Prince 12, her cat, her beloved cat, who lives a strong life of luxury and bears a strong resemblance to Garfield.
Oh, interesting.
This enrages the lady's greedy nephew, Lord Manfred Dargis. who will now only receive a stipend of £50 a week and inherit the grand estate once the prince passes away. The prince is the cat.
So he's what is stopping
Lord,
him from killing
Lord
the cat?
Lord Dargis traps the prince in a picnic basket and throws him into the river. Garfield inadvertently switches places with the prince after John finds the prince climbing out of the drain and takes him to the hotel after mistaking him for Garfield with
wow.
Prince's butler, Smithy. While Princess Butler Smithy finds Garfield in the street and takes him to the Carlisle Castle after
wow.
mistaking him for the prince. In the grand estate Garfield is that he's residing in, he receives a great deal of special treatment, including a butler and a group of four-legged servants and followers, including the prince's loyal bulldog servant, Winston.
Does he get pussy?
Garfield teaches his new animal friends how to make lasagna while Prince learns to adapt to a new...
Hold on. At what point is Garfield making lasagna in the comics?
I think he's just eating the lasagna.
Yeah, but he's teaching his servants to make it to his specifications.
Yeah, he's teaching the servants how to make him his
He's
favorite.
Like, here's how I like it. Now start fucking learning how to do this.
Meanwhile, Prince learns to adapt to his new life with John. Dargis sees Garfield and thinks Prince has come back. If the solicitors see Prince and Garfield, they will not sign the estate over to Dargis, who secretly wants to destroy the castle and barnyard and kill the animals to build a spa resort, causing Miss Abby Westminster, another solicitor, to get suspicious of it.
So he's gay.
Yeah, he wants to build a cruising spa.
Yeah.
Dargis makes many attempts to kill Garfield, including one involving a merciless yet dim-witted Rottweiler named Rommel. Oh.
Rommel.
Nazi reference.
Wow.
Is eventually
Garfield Jewish? No.
I think.
Well, Field.
Yeah, Field. Garfield. He's lazy.
Yeah.
Garfield. Greg Garfield. Eventually, Garfield and Prince meet each other for the first time. They convince the other animals to help them defeat Dargis. Mm. John and Odie discover the mix-up and go to the castle.
This shit's fucking boring, dude.
Which Liz
How
is
long is this?
It's almost over.
All right, let's find out what
Garfield
happens.
And Prince taunt Dargis, whose plan is exposed, and they are seen by the solicitors. Dargis barges in holding a blunderbuss and threatening the solicitors if they do not sign the papers, giving him ownership of the estate and also taking Liz hostage. John attempts to force Dargis to release Liz by holding a crossbow.
Wait, is Liz his bitch?
Liz is his bitch. John's bitch.
Okay.
John attempts to force Dargis to release Liz by holding a crossbow at him, only for Dargis to threaten to kill John for getting involved in the first place.
Mm.
Garfield and Prince, with the help of Odie and John, save the day while Smithy alerts the authorities and Dargis is arrested for his crimes. Garfield, who had been trying to stop John from proposing to Liz, has had a change of heart. He helps
wow.
John propose to Liz, and she says yes.
That's so nice. Is this a live-action movie?
Yeah, I think Bill Murray's in it.
No, Bill Murray, no, he's not.
Breckenmeyer, Jennifer Love Hewitt,
oh,
who's
nice.
Got a big old ass. I don't know if you know that. She's got a
How
big
about
old
Jennifer
dumper.
Jennifer Love huge tits, and it's me.
Billy Connolly, Bill Murray, Tim Curry.
And that's my name.
Yeah. Oh, Tim Curry's
and
the
Bob Hoskins.
Is Tim Curry the butler?
Maybe they voice
Bob
some of
Hoskins.
The
oh, yeah, they probably voice the animals.
How about
yeah.
Tim Slurry? Yeah. He's like, there's a bunch of...
What's over here?
This screen.
Actually,
really
we've
good.
Got a bunch of and ch- over
oh,
here.
Shit. This screenplay was written by Joel.
Oh,
no,
it's a
it
bunch of.
It's not that Cohen. That's how Bill Murray got tricked.
No, he did.
No, it's not.
Look, it says on Wikipedia.
It's not this. I know.
It's written by Alex Sokolow and Joel Cohen.
It's not that Joel Cohen.
He probably just did punch up on the movie.
It's not him, bro. It's a different guy named that.
Mm-hmm.
You don't think there's two Jews in Hollywood named Joel Cohen?
No, because you can't in the Directors Guild. You have to have a middle initial.
Okay. Is that the Directors Guild? Like there's a fucking Wikipedia.
You have to be like Michael B.
Shut
Jordan.
The fuck up.
What?
End this show, man. This man's pissing me off.
No, yeah, you're pissing me off.
You're pissing me off.
I'm
dude.
Looking at Jen Psaki's Twitter feed and getting mad.
Andy's about to arrive.
I'm doing politics.
Okay. All right, we'll end the show so I can get a sandwich, and then we can get all a coffee. Right. And we can get all a coffee. Right. And we can get all a coffee. Right. And we can get all a coffee. And we can get all a coffee. Right. And we can get all a coffee. Right. And we can get all a coffee. Right. And we can get all a coffee. And we can.